So next topic is calcium channel blockers. So in the calcium channel blockers, the drugs will comes under the heterogeneous class of compound. They will act by preventing the entry of calcium ions into the cell, which is required for the contraction of the muscle. Means this drug will block the calcium channel ions, which is responsible for the contraction of the muscle. See, if in angina pectoris, the heart will get contract, and then there is no easy flow of the blood in the heart. So if there is a contraction, means there will be the pressure in the heart, and automatically the blood pressure will raise. So the calcium channel blockers drugs will block the calcium channels, and it will avoid the contraction of the muscles, and it leads to the relaxation of the muscles. So that if the muscles get relaxed, means the blood flow is free in the heart. So next, in this calcium channel blockers, there are three categories. That first one is phenyl alkyl amine derivatives. Second one is benzothiazepine derivatives. Third one, dihydropyridine derivatives. So these three derivatives, that is phenyl alkyl amine derivative, benzothiazepine derivative, and dihydropyridine derivative. This three derivatives will comes under the calcium channel blockers. So next, general mechanism of action of calcium channel blockers. So here what will happen means the drugs directly bind to the calcium channels in the smooth muscles. So it will directly bind to the calcium channels, and it will block the calcium channels, and which is responsible for the contraction of the muscle. So it will block and finally leads to the relaxation of the smooth muscle. So if we see here the mechanism of action of the calcium channel blockers, for example, this, if we take any of the drug belongs to the calcium channel blocker, that is nifedipine, is directly attached to the calcium channels of the smooth muscle. See here, the nifedipine drug is attached to the calcium channels of the smooth muscle, and what will happen means when it is get binded, and it will lead to the block of the calcium channel. So calcium channel will get blocked, and it will block the calcium calmodulin complex. So what it will do after the drug, when it is binding to the calcium channels of the smooth muscles, it will block the calcium calmodulin complex. So if the calcium calmodulin complex will get blocked, means it leads to the inactivation of the myosin light chain kinase. So this enzyme will get inactivated, that is myosin light chain kinase. So it does not allow the myosin to convert it into the myosin phosphate. So finally it leads to the smooth muscle relaxation. So I will explain again mechanism of action. For example, in the calcium channel blockers, if we take the nifedipine and any of the other drugs, it will bind to the calcium channels of the smooth muscles. So it leads to the blockage of the calcium calmodulin complex. So this will calcium calmodulin complex will get blocked, and it leads to the inactivation of the myosin light chain kinase. So this enzyme will get inactivated, and it will inhibit the conversion of the myosin to myosin phosphate. So it leads to the smooth muscle relaxation. So this is the general mechanism of action of calcium channel antagonist. So next one is therapeutic uses. It is used in the treatment of the hypertension, angina, cardiac arrhythmias and hypertrophic cardiomyopathy. So in this heart diseases, this calcium channel blocks are used, that is hypertension, angina pectoris, cardiac arrhythmias and hypertrophic cardiomyopathy. So next, in first one is phenylalkylamine derivatives. So in this, the two drugs will come, that is verapamil and bepridil. Let's see, first drug is verapamil, and this is the structure of the verapamil, and the IUPAC name is 2,3-gamma-4-dimethoxyphenyl-5-2-3-gamma-4-dimethoxyphenyl-ethyl-methyl-amino-2-propane-pentanitrile. So if you see in the structure, that the pentanitrile means 5 carbon atoms are there. See here, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. 5 carbon atoms are there, that is pentane. So for the pentane, in the second position, the 3,4-dimethoxyphenyl is present. See this structure for the phenyl, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So here in the third position and in the fourth position, the methyl methoxy groups are present. See here in third position and the third and the fourth position, the methoxy groups are there. And this is the structure of the phenyl. So 3,4. How many are there? 2. So it is named as dimethoxyphenyl. And here in fifth position, the ethyl group is there. 1, 2. 2 carbon atoms means ethyl. For the second position of the carbon atom, 3,4-dimethoxyphenyl is attached. See here in third position and the fourth position, methoxy groups are there, which are attached to the phenyl group. So it is named as 3,4-dimethoxyphenyl, and this is the ethyl, and this is the methyl amino. See here methyl group is there, here amino group is there. And here in the second position, in the another side, the propane is there. See here, 3 carbon atoms, 1, 2, and 3. So it is named as the propane, and commonly known as the pentanitrile. I will explain it again. Here, the 5 carbon atoms are there. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. So, in the second position of the pentanitrile, here 3,4-dimethoxyphenyl is attached. See here, 3,4-dimethoxyphenyl. And in another second position, the propane is attached. 1, 2, 3. 3 carbon atoms means propane. Here, in the fifth position, the methylamine is attached. And here, ethyl group is attached. 1, 2 carbon atoms means ethyl. And here in the second position of the carbon atom, the 3,4-dimethoxyphenyl is attached. So this is the structure and IUPAC name of the verapamil. Next properties, it is a viscous yellow liquid having the boiling point 246 degrees centigrade, but it is insoluble in water, sparingly soluble in hexane, soluble in benzene and ether, freely soluble in acetone, alcohol, ethyl acetate and chloroform. Means if it is in the form of the liquid, means it is insoluble in water, but it is in the form of white crystalline powder, means it is soluble in water and methanol. Next, pharmacokinetics. It is a oral route of administration. It undergoes the first pass hepatic metabolism, and it can easily bind to the plasma proteins, and it is eliminated through the urine. Means it is a oral route of administration. It undergoes the first pass metabolism, and onset of action is quick, and it is highly binding to the plasma proteins, and finally it is eliminated through the urine. Next, adverse drug reactions are constipation, headache, dizziness, hypotension, bradycardia, means reducing of the blood pressure, congestive heart failure, nausea, tiredness, flushing, shortness of breath, skin itching, rapid weight gain, stomach pain, liver problems, and sweating. Next, uses, it is used in the treatment of the hypertension, angina, and arrhythmias. So it is also used to prevent the stroke, heart attacks, kidney problems, and also prevent the chest pain. And dose 40 to 80 mg orally per day we have to take. Next drug is bipredil hydrochloride. So if you see here structure, this is the bipredil structure, and IUPAC name is N-benzyl N3,2-methylpropoxy-2-pyrrolidine-propylaniline. So if you see here structure, the aniline structure and the benzene structure has been attached to the propane. See here 1, 2, 3. Three carbon atoms are there. So it is the propane. And here in the second position of the propane, the pyrrolidine is attached. See here 5-membered ring with nitrogen, that is pyrrolidine. And here in the third position of the propane, here one of the oxygen group is attached, and this oxygen group is attached to the 2-methylpropane. See here in second position, methyl is there, 1, 2, 3. Three carbon atoms are there. This is methane. So 2-methylpropoxy. This total name is 2-methylpropoxy. I will explain it again, IUPAC name. See here, N-benzyl, 3, in third position of the aniline is attached to this other group. So 3 and 2, see here 2-methyl, here in the second position the methyl is there. So 2-methyl, and this is a propoxy, 1, 2, 3 propane, and this is the oxygen group. So 2-methyl. Propoxy, and in the second position of the propane structure, the pyrrolidine is attached. So 2-pyrrolidine, and this is the propyl aniline. So this is the structure and the IUPAC name of the bipredil. Next properties, it is a white or off-white crystalline powder with bitter taste, slightly soluble in water, soluble in acetone, very slightly soluble in the chloroform and the alcohol. Pharmacokinetics, it is a oral route of administration and metabolized in the liver by cytochrome enzyme, and it undergoes the renal elimination. Next, adverse drug reactions are fatigue or feeling tiredness, nausea, stomach upset, diarrhea, constipation, dry mouth, headache, feeling of the nervousness, dizziness, insomnia is also known as sleep troubling, or tremors, drowsiness, flu syndrome, palpitation means the variations in the heart rate, respiratory infections, abdominal pain, tremors, insomnia, and nervousness. Next uses, it is a calcium channel blocker. It is used to prevent the hypertension and angina. And the dose should be 200 mg once a day. Next, benzothiazepine derivative. So here the drug is diltiazem. So if you see the structure of the drug, that diltiazem, this is the structure. And the IUPAC name is 5-2-dimethylaminoethyl 2,2,4-methoxyphenyl-4-oxo-1,5-benzothiazepine-acetate. So if you see here structure, this is a benzothiazepine. So this is the parent nucleus of in the diltiazem drug. benzo, thiazepine means two benzene rings are there. Thio means sulfur. Azo means nitrogen. So it is named as benzo, thiazepine. So for the benzo, thiazepine structure, in the fifth position, the dimethyl amino ethyl is attached. See here, this one, two carbon atoms there means that is ethyl. In the second position of the ethyl, two dimethyl amino group is attached. So it is named as 5-2-2-dimethyl amino ethyl. And here in the second position, 4-methoxyphenyl is attached. See here in the fourth position, the methoxy is attached to the phenyl structure. So it is named as 4-methoxyphenyl is attached to the second position of the benzothiazepine. And in the fourth position, oxygen group is there. In first position, sulfur. And fifth position, nitrogen is there. And in the third position, acetate group is there. So this is the structure of the diltiazem. I will explain it again. So this is the benzothiazepine parent nucleus. Benzothia means sulfur. Aza means nitrogen. So the for the benzothiazepine structure, in the fifth position of the ethyl 1-2, in the second position of the ethyl, the dimethyl amino group is attached. Dimethyl amino group is attached to the fifth position. And in the second position of the benzothiazepine, the 4-methoxyphenyl is attached. And in the fourth position, oxygen group is attached. And in third position, acetate group is attached. So next properties are, it is a white crystalline powder, freely soluble in water, methanol, methylene chloride, slightly soluble in ethanol, odorless, bitter taste, and it is insoluble in benzene. So pharmacokinetics are, it is a oral and intravenous route of administration. It undergoes a first pass metabolism, but oral route of administration has the low bioavailability, and it undergoes the metabolism through cytochrome enzyme, and it is eliminated through the urine. Means it is oral and intravenous route of administration. It undergoes the metabolism through cytochrome enzyme. And if we compare the intravenous route of administration for oral route of administration, the bioavailability is low. And it is excreted through urine. And adverse drug reactions are dizziness, lightheadedness, weakness, nausea, flushing, constipation, and headache, hypotension, nausea, gastrointestinal disturbance, hepatitis means affect the liver, dermatitis means skin allergy, allergic reactions, tinnitus means that ringing sound in the ears. Thrombocytopenia means the reduce in the platelet count. Means this drug should not be recommended for the pregnant women and the breastfeeding women. Next uses, it is used to prevent the chest pain, and also it may help to increase your the ability to exercise and decrease the angina attacks. And it is a calcium channel blocker. So it works by relaxing the blood vessels in the heart and the body. And also it will reduces the heartbeat. And dose 30 to 60 mg per day. Orally we should take. So next is dihydropyridine derivatives. In dihydropyridine derivatives, the there are two subcategories, that is first generation and second generation. See here, first and second generation. In first generation, the nifedipine drug will come. In the second generation, amlodipine, pelodipine, decardipine, and nimodipine drugs will come. Let's see, first drug is nifedipine. It is a first generation of the drug. And this is the structure. And IUPAC name is 3,5-dimethyl-2,6-dimethyl 4, 2 nitrophenyl, 1 comma 4 dihydropyridine, pyridine, 3 comma 5 dicarboxylate. See, if you see here structure in third position and fifth position, methyl groups are present. And in second and sixth position, dimethyl groups are there. If you see here in the fourth position, the nitro, in second position, nitro group is there. So, 2 nitrophenyl and 3 in third position and fifth position, carboxylate group is there. How many are there? 2. So, it is known as dicarboxylate. I will explain the structure again. In third position and the fifth position, the methyl groups are there. So, 3, comma 5, dimethyl, 2 comma 6 dimethyl, 4 in second position of the phenyl nitro group is there, so 2 nitrophenyl and 3 comma 5 carboxylate. So next properties are, it is the yellow crystalline powder, it is soluble in acetone, chloroform, ethyl acetate, methanol and methylene chloride. So, pharmacokinetics, it is the oral route of administration, is well observed, and it is a quick action, onset of action is quick, and but the duration of action is very short, and it is metabolized in the liver and excreted through the urine. Next, adverse drug reactions are dizziness, headache, drowsiness, nausea, tachycardia means raising of the blood pressure, cough, shortness of the breath, heart failure, hypotension, flushing, edema, and feeling tiredness. So uses, it is used to treat the hypertension, and mostly this drug is not used to, in the treatment of the hypertension. In some cases it is used, and also it is used in the treatment of the angina and also the peripheral vascular diseases, and also it is used as the tocolytic agent. So it is used in the treatment of the angina, peripheral vascular disease. It acts as a tocolytic agent. In some cases, it is used in the treatment of the hypertension, but mostly it is not recommended. And the dose 10 to 20 mg per day we have to take through oral route. Next, amlodipine. This is the structure of the amlodipine, and IUPAC name is 3-ethyl 5-methyl, 2-2-aminoethoxymethyl, 4-2-chlorophenyl, 6-methyl, 1,4-dihydropyridine, 3,5-dicarboxylate. We see here structure in third position, C2H5, ethyl group is there. In the fifth position, methyl group is there. In the second position, 2-aminoethoxymethyl is there. See here, 2-aminoethoxymethyl, and in fourth position, the second position, the chloro atom, chlorine atom is there. So 2-chlorine phenyl, which is attached to the fourth position, and in sixth position, the methyl group is there, and in third and fifth position, the carboxylate groups is there. See again here, IUPAC name, in the third position, the methyl group is there, and in second fifth position, methyl group is there, CH3. So in second position, 2-aminoethoxy and methyl group is there. See here, 2-aminoethoxy methyl group. And here in the fourth position, 2-chlorophenyl is there. In the sixth position, the methyl group is there. In third and fourth, fifth position, the carboxylate group is attached. So this is the structure and IUPAC name of the amlodipine. So next property, sir, it is a white powder, soluble in water, and methanol, ethanol and propanol. So it is a white powder, it is soluble in water, slightly soluble in water and more soluble in ethanol, methanol and propanol. And pharmacokinetics, it is the oral route of administration, and it undergoes the metabolism by cytochrome enzyme and it is excreted through kidneys. And adverse drug reactions are nausea, headache, dizziness, depression, flushing, edema, palpitation, mood changes, pancreatitis, and this dyspepsia, dyspepsonia, and visible disturbances, hepatitis, rashes. So users, it is used as the antihypertensive agent. It may be used as alone or it may be used in the combination form such as ACE inhibitors and diuretics, adrenergic blockers. So this drug is used in the treatment of the hypertension. Maybe this drug is used as a single dose form or it may be used in the combination form like ACE inhibitors, adrenergic blockers or diuretics. And it is also used in the treatment of the angina pectoris, means it is used as the anti-anginal drugs. And it is used in the treatment of the diabetic kidney disease, chest pain, heart failure, and silent heart attacks. So dose 2.5 to 10 mg, oral dose should be taken daily. So next drug is felodipine. So this is the structure of the felodipine. And if you see the IUPAC name, 3-ethyl, 5-methyl, 4-2,3-dichlorophenyl, 2,6-dimethyl, 1,4-hydropyridine, 3,5-carboxylate. So if you see here structure, in the third position, ethyl group, C2H5 ethyl group is attached. In the fifth position, methyl is attached. In the fourth position, in the phenyl group is attached, 2,3-phenyl, 2,3-dichlorophenyl. See here for the phenyl structure in the second position and the third position, chlorine atoms are there. So two chlorine atoms, that is dichlorophenyl, 2,3-dichlorophenyl. In 2,6 position, dimethyl groups are attached. And this is the pyridine structure. In 3,5, two carboxylate groups are attached. I will explain it again. In third position, ethyl. Fifth position, methyl. In fourth position, 2,3-dichlorophenyl. In second and sixth position, dimethyl. And this is the pyridine structure. And 3,5-dicarboxylate. So this is the structure and IUPAC name of the felodipine. Next, properties are, it is a white or yellow crystalline powder. And it is insoluble in water and freely soluble in acetone, ethanol, methanol, methylene chloride. Means it is soluble only in organic solvents. Means it is not soluble in water. And pharmacokinetics are, it is the oral route of administration and it undergoes the metabolism in liver and it is excreted through the urine. So the animal studies have been demonstrated that felodipine will cross the blood-brain barrier and also it will cross through the placenta. So means it is oral route of administration and it is metabolized in the liver by the cytochrome enzyme and it is excreted through the urine. And also this drug is passed through the blood-brain barrier and the placenta. Adverse drug reactions are headache, dizziness, drowsiness, nervousness, weakness, nausea, difficulty in breathing, sneezing, constipation, diarrhea, stomach pain, joint pain, redness, skin rashes, redness of the skin, muscle cramp, irregular heart rate, chest pain, more sweating, swelling of the hands and legs and face. So these are the adverse drug reactions. Uses, it is used to treat the hypertension, angina pectoris, and also it is used to prevent the heart strokes, heart attacks, kidney problems. So it will block the calcium channels in order for the relaxation of the smooth muscles and wide the blood vessels so the blood can easily flow. So dose 2.5 to 10 mg once a day we should take. Next drug is nicardipine, and this is the structure of the nicardipine, and the IUPAC name is 3-2-benzyl-methyl-amino-ethyl-5-methyl-2-6-dimethyl-4-3-nitrophenyl-1,4-dihydropyridine-3,5-dicarboxylate. So if you see here structure, in the third position, the 2-benzyl-methyl-amino-ethyl is attached. See here, benzyl-methyl-amino-ethyl is attached. In fifth position, the methyl group is attached. In second and sixth position, methyl groups are there. So, 2 methyl groups are there. So, it is named as dimethyl. And in fourth position of the pyridine structure, the 3-nitrophenyl. See here, in the third position, the nitro is present. So, this is 3-nitrophenyl and the 3,5-dicarboxylate. I will explain it again. In the third position, 2-benzyl-methyl-amino-ethyl is present. In fifth position, methyl group is there. In second and sixth position, methyl groups are there. That is dimethyl. In the fourth position, 3-nitrophenyl group is attached. In third and the fifth position, the carboxylate group is attached. So this is the structure of an IUPAC name of the nicardipine. Next properties, it is a white crystalline powder and it is soluble in water. Pharmacokinetics are, it is oral, intravenous route of administration. It is metabolized in the liver, eliminated through kidneys. Adverse drug reactions are headache, dizziness or lightheadedness, numbness, stomach upset, constipation, dry mouth, feeling of excessive tiredness, flushing, fast heart rate, muscle cramps, heartburn, increase in the sweating, loss of vision, and sometimes it may cause damage to some of the body parts like brain, heart, blood vessels, kidney, and other body parts. And users, this drug is used to treat the high blood pressure, and also it is used to control the chest pain. And it comes under calcium channel blockers, means it will lower the blood pressure by relaxing the blood vessels. So there is no pressure in the heart, so the heart need not be pumped very hard. So it can also control the chest pain by increasing the supply of the oxygen to the heart. Dose 20 to 40 mg oral drip, means if you take to the oral dose, means 20 to 40 mg per day. Means if you take to the intravenous route of administration, means 0.5 to 2 mg per hour. Next drug is nimodipine. This is the structure of the nimodipine. IUPAC name is 3-2-methoxy-ethyl-5-propane-2,6-dimethyl-4-nitrophenyl-1,4-dihydropyridine-3,5-dicarboxylate. If you see here structure, in third position, the methoxy-ethyl group is there. Methoxy-ethyl group is there in the third position. And in the fifth position, the propane structure is there. And in the sixth position, here in the sixth position, the sixth position and the second position, the methyl group is there. So that is dimethyl. In the fourth position, the 3-nitrophenyl is there. See here, in the third position, the nitro group is attached to the phenyl groups. This is a 3-nitrophenyl is attached at the fourth position of the pyridine structure. and then 3,5 dicarboxylate is present. I will explain it again. See here, in the third position, the 2-methoxyethyl is there, and in fifth position, the propane structure is there. So in second and the sixth position, the dimethyl groups are there, and in the fourth position, 3-nitrophenyl group is there. And in third position and the fifth position, the carboxylic groups are there. So this is the structure and IUPAC name of the nemodipine. Next properties are, it is the yellow crystalline powder, and it is soluble in ethyl acetate and sparingly soluble in ethanol and soluble in water. And next, pharmacokinetics. Pharmacokinetics, it is an oral route and intravenous route of administration, and it is metabolized in the liver by using the cytochrome enzymes, and it is eliminated through the urine and the fecus. Next, adverse drug reactions are flushing, headache, nausea, dizziness, palpitation, constipation, vomiting, sweating, unusual heart rate, means it may increase the or decrease the heart rate, fainting, low blood pressure, thrombocytopenia, means decrease in the platelet count, sweating, muscle pain, and liver damage. So uses, it is used to decrease the problems due to certain type of bleeding in the brain, means it is, if there is a bleeding in the brain, means it is used to stop the bleeding, that bleeding in the brain, and it is also used in the treatment of the high blood pressure, and also it is used, means it is not regularly used to treat the head injuries, means mainly it is used to treat the heart disease, that means which are related to the heart diseases, but in some cases only it is used to treat the brain, like a head injury, and also it is used to prevent the seizures in the women, means mainly it is used to prevent the blood pressures and angina pectoris, means the diseases which are related to the heart. And the diseases which are related to the head, in some cases we are going to use, but not in all the time. Next dose. The oral dose should be 60 mg per every 4 hours we should take. So 60 mg we should take for every 4 hours, that should be taken after the meals. Means the drug should be taken after the meals. So these are the drugs which comes under the calcium channel blockers. That is in calcium channel blockers, 3 subclasses are there. That is phenyl alkyl amine derivatives, benzodiazepine, and dihydropyridine derivatives. So in phenyl alkyl amine derivatives, 2 drugs will come, that is verapamil and bepridil. And next, in benzodiazepine derivatives, example is diltiazem. Next, last classification is dihydropyridine derivatives. So in this first generation, second generation will come. In first generation, nifedipine, amlodipine, felodipine, nicardipine, and nimodipine. So these all the drugs which comes under the calcium channel blockers. So these are the references books for this topic. That is the textbook of the medicinal chemistry, volume 1 by V. Algaraswamy, and the volume 2 by V. Algaraswamy, and the medicinal chemistry by Ramarao Nandela, and essential of the medicinal chemistry by Andrejus Porol Kovas, and next Fayer's principle of the medicinal chemistry, and next medicinal chemistry by Adhoshkar, and the medicinal and the pharmaceutical chemistry by Hari Krishna Singh and V.K. Kapoor and Wilson, and Giswold textbook of organic medicinal and pharmaceutical chemistry. So these are the textbooks. differences textbook books for the anti-angina topics.